Today, I'm going to discuss a very important topic of algae, types of life cycles in algae. This topic is in the syllabus of BSc Semester 1 Botany and also in MSc previous algae course. When we talk about life cycle, it means every organism goes through a series of developmental stages or changes during its lifetime. So, life cycle constitute all these developmental stages. In algae, different types of life cycles are present. It shows wide variation. Whereas in angiosperms, all the plants are diploid and the haploid stage is restricted only to the gametes. In algae, the main types of life cycles that are found are haplontic, diplontic, isomorphic, heteromorphic and triphasic. Triphasic life cycle is of two types, haplobiontic and diplobiontic. In algae, growth and development passes through different and distinct morphological and cytological stages, and the sequence of these changes is termed as life cycle or life history. First, I will discuss the haplontic life cycle. As the name suggests, all the stages are haploid. Only the zygote is diploid. And this type of life cycle is found in many algae. Some of the examples are Chlamydomonas, Volvox, Edogonium and Cara. So the main plant body in haplontic type of life cycle is gametophyte. In the gametophyte, gametangia are found. In the gametangia, haploid gametes are formed. After the syngamy or fusion of two gametes, a diploid zygote is formed. And this zygote is the only diploid stage. Soon after the formation of zygote, meiosis occurs. And after meiosis, haploid meiozoospores are formed, which germinate to form the gametophytic thallus. So in the haplontic life cycle, only one type of thallus is found, which is gametophytic. All the stages in the life cycle except the zygote, all stages are haploid. The second type of life cycle is diplontic life cycle. It is observed in navicula, which is also known as diatom, belonging to the class Bacillariophyceae, and also in sargassum, which is a brown alga belonging to the class Phaeophyceae. In diplontic life cycle also, there is only one type of thallus present, but this type of thallus is sporophytic or diploid. In the sporophytic thallus, diploid gametangia are present. In the gametangia, at the time of gamete formation, meiosis or reduction division occurs. And gametes are the only haploid stage in the life cycle. Soon after the formation of gametes, gametes fuse, and after syngamy, diploid zygote is formed. This zygote germinates to form the diploid sporophytic thallus. The third type of life cycle is isomorphic life cycle. It is observed in alva, which is a green alga belonging to Chlorophyceae, and also in Ectocarpus and Dictyota, which are brown algae. In isomorphic type of life cycle, two types of plant body or thallus are present. One is gametophytic thallus, that is haploid, and another one is sporophytic thallus, which is diploid. And these thallus alternate with each other. Gametophytic thallus forms the sporophytic thallus and sporophytic thallus forms the gametophytic thallus. And since both of these are morphologically similar, so this type of alternation of generation is known as isomorphic alternation of generation. So in this type of life cycle, gametophytic thallus has gametangia. Gametangia have gametes. Gametes fuse to form a zygote. The diploid zygote forms another thallus, which is sporophytic or diploid thallus. In the sporophytic thallus, diploid sporangia are present. In the sporangia, meiosis occurs, and zoospores that are formed after meiosis are haploid, and these are known as meiozoospores. Meiozoospores germinate to form the haploid or gametophytic thallus. The fourth type of life cycle is heteromorphic life cycle. It is observed in laminaria and cutlaria. These are brown algae of class Phaeophyceae. So as the name suggests, heteromorphic life cycle also has two generations or two types of thallus. One is gametophytic or haploid, and another one is sporophytic or diploid. But both these thallus are morphologically dissimilar. So this type of alternation of generation or life cycle is known as heteromorphic. The gametophyte has gametangia. In the gametangia, haploid gametes are formed. Haploid gametes after syngamy form zygote. Zygote germinates to form diploid sporophytic thallus. This is different morphologically from the gametophyte. In the sporophytic thallus, diploid sporangia are present. In the sporangia, after meiosis, haploid meiozoospores are formed, and which germinate to form the haploid thallus. The fifth type of life cycle is triphasic haplobiontic life cycle. It is observed in red algae, but trachospermum and nemalion. So the name suggests triphasic means there are three phases or three types of thallus in the life cycle. And haplobiontic means ki gametophyte is haploid and the two other phases are also haploid. For example, gametophytic thallus, which is haploid thallus, has the oogonia or female gametangia known as carpogonia. In the carpogonia, female gamete or egg is formed. In the male gametophytic thallus, antheridia or male gametangia is known as spermatangia. In the spermatangia, male gamete or spermatia are formed. Egg and spermatia fuse, and after syngamy, a diploid zygote is formed. This diploid zygote germinates on the female gametophyte and forms a carposporophyte. But carposporophyte is formed after meiosis. So carposporophyte is haploid. It is parasitic on the female gametophyte. In the carposporophyte, carposporangia are present in which haploid carpospores are formed. These carpospores germinate and develop to form centrentia stage, which is also haploid, and this third centrentia stage develops into the gametophytic thallus. The last type of life cycle is triphasic diplobiontic life cycle. It is found in Polysiphonia and Gracilaria, which are also red algae belonging to the class Rhodophyceae. In this type of life cycle, there are also three phases are present. Therefore, it is called triphasic. One is gametophyte, second is carposporophyte, and third is tetrasporophyte. Gametophyte is the haploid stage, whereas carposporophyte and tetrasporophyte are diploid stage. So this is known as triphasic diplobiontic life cycle. The male gametophyte has antheridia or spermatangia. Female gametophyte has carpogonia or oogonia. In the carpogonia, female gamete or egg is formed. In the spermatangia, male gamete or spermatia are formed. Egg and spermatia fuse, and after syngamy, diploid zygote is formed. But the difference is here, zygote without undergoing meiosis directly forms the carposporophyte. So the carposporophyte is diploid. In the carposporophyte, diploid carpospores are formed, which germinate to form the diploid tetrasporophyte. Now in the tetrasporophyte, tetrasporangia are present. In the tetrasporangia, After reduction, division, or meiosis, haploid tetraspores are formed. Out of the four tetraspores that are formed per tetrasporangia, two germinate to form the male gametophyte and two germinate to form the female gametophyte. So, the life cycle is triphasic and diplobiontic.